to put an instructor widget in your course, you're going to click on the course. Once you're in the course, there's two things you have to do. First, you have to create the widget, and then you have to put the widget on your home page. So to create the widget, you're going to click on Course Resources, go to Course Admin. In Course Admin, you're going to click on Widgets. In Widgets, you're going to click on Create a Widget. Once you're at the New Widget screen, you're going to, under New Widget Properties, put the name of your widget. Mine's Chuck Becker Instructor. You can put a description if you want to. Then you're going to click on Content. For your instructor widget, your content's normally a picture of you and your contact information. Although you can put pretty much anything in this widget that you want, I would keep it fairly short. So I'm going to paste my contact information into the contents. Then I'm going to add a photo of myself. Normally you'll be pulling this off your computer. Once you have your picture and your contact information, you're going to save and close. Now you've made a custom widget. Now, if you have several courses, you will actually have to recreate this widget in each course if it's a course level custom widget. So I would copy the information or know where I get that information easily, so I don't have to hunt around for it or type stuff in new each time. Since I'm done with the widget, I click back into my course. I'm at my course home page. I'm going to scroll down to the bottom of the course home page, and in the square with the three dots that turns blue when my hand is over it, the square with the three dots, I'm going to click on that square and I'm going to click on Manage Home Pages. This brings up the Home Pages screen. What's important here is that the home page that you originally have is a default home page. So when I scroll down, I notice this PCC Daylight Course Home Default, and it's active and it's the default home page. I need to click on the chevron, the little down arrow, and make a copy of that page. That copy will appear right below the active home page. Then I need to go to where it says active home page, and in the menu, I need to pick my copy. And once I've picked my copy, I need to apply it. Then, when I click back into my course, I'm on the copy of that default home page. What that allows me to do is edit my home page. So when I scroll down to the bottom and go to the square with the three dots and click on it, I now can edit the home page. I click on Edit, and it brings me up to Edit Home Page. Once I'm here, I scroll down a little bit to a gray area where you'll notice I can insert widgets. The default setup for home pages is the basic plus layout. So most people will put their announcements on the left side. They'll put the D2L support page at the bottom. And on the right side, they'll put their widget, the librarian's widget, the tutoring center, things such as that. To put your widget there and other system widgets, you click Add Widgets. And when this screen comes up, you'll notice these are the system widgets. And so you can add system widgets such as Ask a Librarian. There it is. And to add your widget, you would go to Custom Widget. And in Custom Widget, you pick the widget you just made. You can browse for it or you can search for it. So I click on Chuck Becker Instructor and I add the widget. Once the widget is at the bottom of this right side, I can grab the widget and I can pull it past other widgets to place it on the very top. And it probably should be the top widget. Then when I'm done with the layout of my page, I save and close. You'll notice my widget appears on the right side of the page. You may ask yourself, why do I need my information on the right side of the course homepage if I also, say, place it in the announcements or if it's in my syllabus? The reason is there's no reason not to include your information as many times as possible. The main part, or the main reason, is that it's always there, so it's very easy for students to find once they get to your main page.